intensify. Do not lead me to the will of my foes, O Lord, for false witnesses rise up against me, and they breathe out violence. Today's intentions for the Holy Mass are my intentions will be for Tony and Dorothy Rausch, and Father Dan's intention will be for the intentions of Heather Zoll. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, so we can more worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, grant us so to celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion that we may merit to receive your pardon. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear me, O islands. Listen, O distant peoples. The Lord called me from birth. From my mother's womb he gave me my name. He made of me a sharp-edged sword and concealed me in the shadow of his arm. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver he hid me. You are my servant, he said to me, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Though I thought I had toiled in vain, and for nothing, uselessly, spent my strength. Yet my reward is with the Lord, and my recompense is with my God. For now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him, and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, he says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing of your salvation. In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me and deliver me. Incline your ear to me and save me.
I will sing of your salvation.
Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. For you are my rock and my fortress. O my God, rescue me from the hand of the wicked.
I will sing of your salvation.
For you are my hope, O Lord, my trust, O God, from my youth. On you I depend from birth, and from my mother's womb you are my strength.
I will sing of your salvation.
My mouth shall declare your justice, day by day your salvation. O God, you have taught me from my youth, until the present I proclaim your wondrous deeds.
I will sing of your salvation.
Reclining at table with his disciples, Jesus was deeply troubled and testified, Amen, amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me. The disciples looked at one another at a loss as to whom he meant. One of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining at Jesus' side. So Simon Peter nodded to him to find out what he meant. He leaned back against Jesus' chest and said to him, "Master, who is it?" Jesus answered, "It is the one to whom I hand the morsel after I have dipped it." So he dipped the morsel and took it and handed it to Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot. After Judas took the morsel, Satan entered him. So Jesus said to him, "What you are going to do, do quickly." Now none of those reclining at the table realized why he said this to him. Some thought that since Judas kept the money back, Jesus had told him, "Buy what we need for the feast," or to give something to the poor. So Judas took the morsel and left at once, and it was night. When he had left, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and he will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little while longer. You will look for me, and as I told the Jews, where I go, you cannot come. So now I say it to you." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, where are you going?" Jesus answered him, "Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, though you will follow later." Peter said to him, "Master, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for you." Jesus answered, "Will you lay down your life for me? Amen, amen, I say to you, the cock will not crow before you deny me three times." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, everyone. Deacon Buster, Father Nick, and I are here celebrating this Mass, this Holy Mass for Tuesday of Holy Week. Later this morning, we will virtually travel down to the cathedral to celebrate what is called the Chrism Mass. Every year on Tuesday of Holy Week, a Chrism Mass is celebrated, and two important things, very important things, happen at that Chrism Mass. The first is that priests renew their commitments. There are 130 of us, and every year on Tuesday of Holy Week, we stand before the bishop and we renew the promises that we made on the day we were ordained priests. And secondly, more importantly, the oils that will be used in the sacramental life of the church will be blessed and consecrated. Both of those things, the renewal of priestly promises and the blessing and consecration of oil, both of those are future things. They're things that will happen in the year ahead. It seems like, you know, so many people were focused on today. How are we going to follow the rules, and how are we going to slow the spread? How are we going to cure this COVID illness? And we forget that there's something on the other side of COVID. And that's what this celebration is about. If there was nothing on the other side of COVID, then we wouldn't have to do this celebration. We go play golf, or we go have coffee or breakfast somewhere. But there's a bright future for all of us to consecrate the oil of catechumens for all the babies. Think about all the babies, your children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren and nieces and nephews who will be blessed with the oil that will be blessed today by our bishop for the oil of the sick, for those seriously ill. And finally, sacred chrism, which is olive oil to which perfume is added, which is used in three sacraments. First, for babies, all the babies who will be baptized. Secondly, for young people, confirmed. Think of all the teenagers, 6th and 7th graders, who will be confirmed with the oil that is to be consecrated today, the sacred chrism. And finally, for holy orders. 6 weeks from today, Deacon Buster will be ordained a priest, and his hands will be consecrated with the oil that will be consecrated today in the cathedral, just a few hours from now. Not just a Deacon Buster to become Father Buster, ordained and consecrated with oil, but also The final use of chrism is to anoint the walls of a new church. And so, not 6 weeks from now, but 6 months from now, the walls of the new church we're building will be consecrated with the sacred chrism that we are about to consecrate, the bishop is about to consecrate today. And so it's important. This is an important celebration which will happen in a few hours. Right now, the oil is just a jug. It's a jug of oil, and it's sitting on a table. But in a few hours, it will become something wondrous to guide us and to guide the church in the year ahead for all of the sacraments we will celebrate. Provided the bishop remembered to go to the store to get it last night. Provided the bishop remembered to go to the jug store.
Get it? The drug store?
Provided the bishop remembered to go to the jug store, the oil right now is simply oil. But in a few hours, it will be so much more than oil. To consecrate the life of the church in the year ahead, In the prayer of consecration, or the prayer of commitment, the bishop will say, "Are you resolved?" He'll say to Father Nick and I and the other 128, he'll say, "Are you resolved to renew the promises you once made?" There is a part, I'm not sure exactly what he's going to say, because it says, "Are you resolved to renew in the presence of the bishop and God's holy people?" So we won't be in his presence. He'll be down there, we'll be here watching virtually. I'm not sure exactly what he's going to say. He may say, "In the virtual presence of the bishop," or he may omit that line. I can't wait to see or to hear what he says. I'm not sure what he'll say, but I know what I'm going to say. I know what Father Nick is going to say. Are you resolved? Are you resolved to renew the promises you made? My answer, absolutely. I am resolved. That we are. We're all resolved, all of us priests, resolved to faithfully minister these sacraments, which are a strength to us and a strength to our church. This is a time of intense prayer. Holy Week, next week, the octave of Easter, this is a time of intense prayer. Bless our bishop, bless all of us priests, bless all of our families, bless our healthcare workers, those who are sick, those who will become sick. We pray, oh Lord, move us through this time to see the bright promise of the future that you have in store for us. May we all be faithful in our commitments, in whatever our commitments, whatever our promises, may we be faithful. One day, may we find our way to heaven. For this we pray, amen. Please stand.
Let us now offer all of our prayers and intentions to our Heavenly Father.
For all members of the Church, may Christ strengthen us as we share the good news of the Gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders and those who carry responsibility for the welfare of others, may Jesus guide them in the ways of servant leadership. Let us pray to the Lord.
O Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are struggling or suffering, may God's love and presence with them bring consolation and comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
O Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those gathered here, may God open our hearts more fully and increase our faith in Him. Let us pray to the Lord.
O Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they rest in the loving presence of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the vine, Lord, of your hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed is he now forever.
Us not into temptation. Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you have fed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.